Sir Alistair, what is the meaning of this?
Your Grace, my deepest apologies for appearing before you, covered in blood as I am. But I can only reaffirm my allegiance to you and assure you that the mission you gave me was a success. The woman you wanted dead has been dealt with, and I have brought you her child as proof of my good faith.
Guards, take the child. And what of Sir Valar?
He came between you and I, Your Grace, but I completed my task despite any blood ties I may have had with him. I fulfilled my end of the bargain. Now, what of yours?
I detect a hint of insolence from you, Sir Alistair. But you have fulfilled your obligations, and I will honor my side of the bargain. A Lannister always pays his debts. I return your titles and your lands to you. Riverspring is yours. You may rise, Lord Sarwyn.
¿Dónde costó esa baby? Only a single baby. Isn't that a low price?
Lord Robson still requests repayment of the 10,000 dragons he loaned your late father. Lady Catloop is seeking redress for the wrongs caused to her young daughter by Squire Bilcombe's cousin. Forworth, our blacksmith, requests an audience to complain about the tax on wood. If I might say so, my lord, you did what you had to do and accepted your responsibilities. There is once again a Lord Sarwyck at the head of River Spring, and I thank the gods for that. Your father would be proud of you.
But at what price, Howin? Father and Garwin are dead. My bastard half-brother murdered Elyana right before my eyes. The people of Riverspring. Why did so many have to die? And Mors, I killed my best friend, a man who was practically my brother. This, 15 years after I took the lives of his family. And to what end? To hold Riverspring? To hold on to a name? Open your eyes, Harwin. Riverspring is now nothing but a lifeless heap of stone, and the Sarwyck name hangs by a thread. I've betrayed. I've murdered. I've lost everything. The strength of the Sarwicks lies neither in their lands nor in their name, but rather in the blood of their people.
My lord, I won't allow you to talk that way. I know what you have endured, but you saved the honor of House Sarwyck. That is worth more than stone or blood. You are Lord Sarwyck. You have a name to uphold.
I care not for my name, Harwin. What good is a name with no one to carry it on? What good is a town without a soul?
It's not just your name, Lord Alistair. It's your father's name, and it's all that's left of him. Don't destroy it. You have a town to rebuild. Your people need you.
You're not listening to me, Harwin. Leave me be.
What an asshole!
Get out.
What the fucking asshole? Well, if it was going to be like this, why kill the fucking child? Now all that's left is that we're expelled. And he's going to commit suicide! Okay, that was fun. Yeah, what a moronic person. All that effort to commit suicide, what a fucking idiot. If he couldn't live with the consequences of his actions, then he shouldn't have done those things. I never imagined that would be the end of the character. But there you go. I made him emo. No, I made him into a ruthless careerist. He had a goal to become Lord Sarwick. I made all I had to make it happen. Yeah, he couldn't live with the Orden of Power. Crazy shit. I can truly say this is the only epilogue of a game where your character is going to kill himself. That's the ending, your character committing suicide out of regret for his actions. Never seen that before, nor I think I'll see it again. Yeah. Well, but the Illusive Man is not the protagonist, and the Illusive Man was being controlled, was he not? That would be a brave thing to do. To kill himself, to free himself from the influence of the machines. Just like Saren does in the first game. This guy is just an idiot. Yeah, he spent the whole game arguing that you should follow the orders because they are your orders. But he was unwilling to give those orders. That's his problem. Which I don't understand. If you don't have a problem following awful orders, why would you have a problem giving them? Yeah, he was a weak. A weak link. Crazy shit. But that's it. Successful completion of the Lord difficulty. Playthrough. That's not the ending you would expect, but I'm not disappointed really. This plausible in any event. But yeah, I'm not going to end it right away. I'm going to see what happens with the other ending, letting the child live. I want to see if the queen appoints me anyway. That would be crazy. But overall, a great game with the same flow as Dragon Age, I have to say. The rogues are overpowered, and there is nothing you can do about it. And the second big flaw is that they give you Alistair, which is a weak character, and he has no backup for a long stretch of the beginning of the game, which makes him just too fucking easy to kill. And not very easy to handle. But yeah, that's it. So, let's go for the bonus scene and let's take a look at what happens if you choose the other option.